Hey, what's up guys, it's Rochelle, and today we're playing Telltale's Michonne Episode 3, What We Deserve. Yeah, I just finished Episode 2 the day before, so I am gonna record and upload this, so yeah. I'm gonna recap my choices. Let's see, okay, this is Episode 1. Episode 2, I stopped Pete, he's with us, and that kind of resulted in us killing some people from Norma's camp, so that's bad, I guess. I don't know what would happen if we let him go. I had a feeling that maybe they would kill Pete, so I kept him with us. I picked up the phone, talked to Donna, I guess. I did not tell Paige I committed suicide, and I spoke directly to Norma on the walkie-talkie, and I did not kill Randall. So I have no idea how that's gonna play. So let's just start. Okay, oh yeah, this is the finale, so... oh boy, I'm so nervous. Recap.
Randall should be the one laying there, not your brother.
Oh yeah, we still don't know what happened to Zachary and his friend.
I'm not leaving you behind.
Quote unquote friend.
You start butchering their people, and our chances of making it out of here, any of us, go down to zero.
They had some supplies just sitting out, and Norma caught me. I didn't think she was going to, but she let me go.
So yeah, because of that, I feel like she has some mercy and a bit of a soft spot too.
Michonne, what is it?
So maybe if we didn't kill Randall, we have a chance. And that's the didn't.
Yes, that means the dance is over.
Ugh.
Your funeral.
Whatever it is, I just don't like to do that to people in my hands. Even if they're like so evil, I couldn't do that. It makes me feel like I'm not human. Like, I just hope that they become better people somehow, or just hope they get what they deserve. Leave it to fate. Oh my god. Wait, we're in the boat? Oh, okay, flashback. Maybe to when they just found us?
Hope you're not thinking about jumping. Because if you do, I'm gonna have to come in after you. Not looking forward to that. Water's gonna be an ice bath.
Really, you'd come after me?
You're one of us now. And I can't be the only brains around here.
Right.
Oh, freezing my ass off. Yeah. Coffee will warm you up. Go on.
Wow, he's actually nice.
You'll be glad you did.
And I always thought he was a jerk. Guess not.
God damn, Oak. You can't call it coffee when more than half's whiskey.
You sound like my ex-wife. She was more of a rum girl.
About the kittens who took over the boat?
What? Oh, no.
Birdo, no.
It was a mutiny.
Birdo,
No, just stop it now, okay? I'm warning you.
Damn, man.
I despised a lot of them when I first got on board, but they grow on you. Like mold, they are. Nah, sorry, that's shit, isn't it?
They're growing on me, too. Kinda nice that people can still joke around.
It's a fine line between the court jester and the village idiot. You can guess which side I think he's on. Before I joined up with Pete, my brother and I were cooped up in an old canning factory. Food for ages. Lot of fat and happy people. But then a young girl got taken. We followed her trail. It wasn't hard with all the blood. Ended up cornering the people who took her in this warehouse. All 10 of us went in. Only I came out.
You did the right thing.
And it got my brother killed. The right thing can kiss my ass.
I actually chose the first option, but I don't know.
A few weeks later, I came across Pete, ways up the coast. He saw that look on my face and he offered me a job. Didn't ask any questions, didn't turn me away, just welcomed me in. Pete's a good goddamn egg in a rotten world.
I don't always get Pete, but I'm glad people like him still exist.
I'll drink to that. Well, I think Berto's little routine is winding down, so we can finally play cards. Care to join us? It'd be nice to have you there. Besides, none of us can remember the rules.
Yeah.
So, it'd be the most unique game of Go Fish you've ever played.
Yeah. Do me in.
Sounds like
a challenge.
We
need some positivity in the world to distract
us. You won't regret it when I win that machete of yours.
Oh. No, I like him. When the flashback like that happens, it always means somebody's gonna die. Or everyone's gonna die. And I'm such a pessimist.
Are you sure you want to do this? I need to see him. I need to see that bastard's face.
Well, hey there, Michonne. Sam, I knew you couldn't stay away.
Don't fucking talk to me.
Just leave.
Sam, stop.
I'm not gonna help.
Easy, all right? Jesus.
Little help here. Please, I need a hand. Hey, let go of me. Thank you. Why did you stop me? What are you... Why are you protecting him? You know what he did.
You should be better than that, Sam. Don't be like him.
Or like you? Just stating the obvious here. What's funny here is you think me and my sister are the bad ones. But you're the one who burned down our home. Forced our people on the shore to be easy pickings for the walkers.
What?
Families, kids, never did shit to you.
We didn't hurt anybody.
Didn't stop to think about all the lives you were screwing up. All the shit they had to leave behind.
Ignore him, Michonne.
Yeah.
Probably burned beyond recognition now.
I'm not gonna say anything.
You did that.
You did. What did you do to the people on the boat?
I'm not.
You killed other kids.
Upsetting you, am I?
He's only trying to piss you off.
You're done talking. You're the one who should be dead.
Sam, calm down.
My dad isn't even in the fucking ground yet, and you want me to calm down?
I didn't mean
he ruined everything. He killed...
Tufty.
We don't know.
Wait. You hear that?
Answer me. Now. Michonne? You don't want to keep me waiting.
I'm right here.
Good. You might be sitting pretty, thinking you have the upper hand. But your luck has changed.
Michonne and Sadiq. They got the rest of the crew, too.
Oh, boy. Can we just trade?
Look, whatever this bitch asks, don't...
Sadiq!
Don't worry. They're all in good hands here. But them staying that way is up to you. So listen closely. I'm willing to trade my brother for your friends.
Didn't kill us.
But anything you do to Randall, I will do to them. Do you understand?
Look, you don't owe me anything, but please, we have to get them back.
That's my deal, Michonne.
Sorry.
I understand.
I feel like, what I like to hear. Any option I choose for...
We'll be there by sunrise.
Will result in something
bad. Be ready
bad.
For us.
Shit.
So... what do you think's going to happen next?
Shut up. Feeling somebody... you're going to kill someone. Or everyone. Why, love? Why did you put a gun in my head? Episode 3, What We Deserve. The titles are always foreshadowing something. Consequences, I guess. Maybe I should just let Pete surrender himself.
What? There's something on my face.
The bruises aren't so bad, right?
Just wipe the blood off.
I'm pretty sure she'll notice the fingers.
Yeah, at least I don't have to see his ugly face anymore.
This has to work.
Keep on hoping if you want.
It could be worse, you know. At least he's not dead. We'll get our friends back. Alive.
That's if Norma keeps her word. The minute you hand him over, she's gonna take that bag off his head. What then?
You all have no idea what you're in for.
It's only a few punches at the face. It was out of self-defense. Right. Come on, don't listen to him.
Norma's not gonna leave us alone. She won't stop just because we gave her brother back. Sure, you kept him alive, but we still burned all their shit. So we run. After you trade for your friends, we haul ass to the back gate and get the hell out of here. But she'd take the house. Let her have it.
Wouldn't she expect us to run?
So what? She knows where we are now. Hiding isn't an option. So let's just go. Stop.
It might work.
We just have to be quick. The minute your guys are inside, we're out of here. I can't fucking listen to this.
What? Sam, where are you going?
I'll watch him.
Oh, tough choices.
Sam!
Oh boy. I feel like the choices in like Telltale is always so hard. Like what to say or whatever. Compared to like... Oh my god.
Sam, stop. You're gonna hurt yourself.
God damn it.
We're gonna do it. Let us do it.
Sam,
come on.
Stop. Maybe you're all ready to walk away, but I'm not just gonna leave him like this.
Let's just bury the body, come on. There's a shovel over there.
We couldn't give my mom a real funeral. My dad and I had to bury her here. Just the two of us. He'd want to be with her. That's all I can give him.
I understand. He should be buried with your mom.
But we can't focus on that right now. We have to be ready to leave.
I'm not going.
What? Sam, you can't still be thinking
my mom is here, Paige.
Everything I have of her. And Greg, if you want to leave, go ahead, but I'm not coming with you.
We have to leave. You can't stay here. Oh god. How about your brother? You still have two more brothers there. Whoa.
I'm sorry.
You have to think about your brother, Sam.
This house meant everything to my dad. It's all I have left. I'm not just going to abandon it.
I know you don't want to, but leaving might be your only option. It isn't safe here anymore.
I'm going to die.
I can't just give up. We can fight. We can defend this house.
No, come on. Home is wherever you are with your family.
Thank you. I owe you my life. Sorry it took me so long to say it.
I'm just gonna carry her out of here.
Sam, stop.
Please.
I have to stop her. Logical a bit. Sorry, Sam. God.
Maybe I can't help him, but I'm not gonna let Norma take the rest of my family from me.
So follow us, bring your brothers with us.
I've got some weapons stashed in my room. Old duffel bag. Should look familiar. You should make sure everyone's armed before Norma gets here.
Yeah.
It's getting worse. Let's see.
I was just wanted to know what it felt like. I wasn't gonna shoot it. Just.
And how does it feel?
It's heavy.
Empty.
Can I help? I want to do something.
Yeah. He needs to learn.
Sure, go ahead. Those slide in there. Round side forward.
It's like teaching Clementine.
They just die like that. Greg and Dad. I thought we were safe here. What am I supposed to do?
You have to be smart. That's how you survive.
My dad was the smartest guy I knew. That didn't save him. The guy who did it killed my dad. He's gotta... I mean... the things he said... the way he was laughing about Dad. He can't get away with it.
We have to give Randall back to his sister, James.
I heard you guys talking. There's more people coming to the house. Sam's hurt. If she... they can't hurt her too. You have to stop them.
Sam needs you right now. Go. Help her.
Mm-hmm. Family keeps you strong.
Here. I don't know if I'm ready. You know, to have one.
Hang on to this.
I'm gonna trust him.
You might need it. Norma's on her way. Things could go wrong in a hurry.
I'll be careful.
He seems like a smart kid. Even though he's young. Family is the one that keeps you going.
She didn't always come to this.
It's like those villains who say it's like family and love keeps you weak. They don't know anything. Oh boy.
Janie, Rich, what's hold up? Prisoner's not cooperating. What do you want to do? Yeah, we don't have time for this. Get him moving.
Okay. Hand out guns to Pete, Paige, and Sam. Where are the other guns? Oh wait, we're just gonna have to find them. Because we have the guns.
Is that music?
Oh no, it's getting worse. How is this gonna help? Oh my god, never-ending hallway. Getting further and further.
Come in.
Oh, so cute.
I like that. It's pretty.
My dad gave it to me, so I wouldn't have to hear the things out there. As long as I stay in my fortress, I'm safe. It keeps all the bad stuff out. I put pillows and blankets against the wall.
Was this your dad's idea?
Yeah. My dad makes sure I'm always safe, so nothing can happen to me. Ever. Especially not those... things. I know what those monsters out there are. Wendigo.
Wendigo.
Grandma told me about
that. Until Dawn reference.
It's what happens when someone eats another person.
Well, close enough.
I hadn't heard that one before.
Do they scare you too? They make lots of noise, even at night.
Getting scared is normal.
Really?
Happens to everyone sometimes.
But my dad's not scared of them. I've been waiting for him. Where is he? Why didn't he come get me yet?
I wonder if this is a Native American family.
Where's my dad?
He can't come right now.
I want to wait here for my dad.
Alex.
I want my dad!
Oh no.
I just... I want my dad. I want Greg back. I want everything to go back to the way it was. Daddy.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I couldn't bring your brother home.
When Greg, when he, did he become one of them? It's what happens, right? He did, didn't he?
No, your brother didn't become one of them. Greg is still Greg.
Is that what's gonna happen to me? Am I gonna die and change into one too?
No. I'm going to protect you. Nothing out there will hurt you.
God, he's like, was he like Clementine's age?
Thanks.
Clementine is so much tougher.
Coming up on the road now. Hey, keep the chatter to a minimum. Our friends are listening.
Thanks for letting me see your fortress.
Oh boy.
James Fairbanks, Alex Fairbanks.
Oh my god, that's like a jump scare. Oh. Yeah, I'll give her ammo. She has a sniper or whatever.
Oh, hey, I didn't hear you come in.
Here.
Were you able to talk some sense into her? Or do you still think digging a hole is a good use of Sam's time? I've never seen her like this. She's not thinking.
Sam wants to defend the house. She wants to fight.
You're kidding. Norma's got more people, more guns. There's no way we'd win in that fight. I don't know why Sam thinks she can protect her brothers here.
At least someone's thinking straight.
I'll be out of your hair soon enough. Never belonged here anyway. Same as you. That's one thing we got in common. Squatters and other people's lives.
But that's not why you're leaving.
I mean, it's part of it. Call it self-preservation, but I've gotten pretty used to knowing when it's time to cut and run. Norma's gonna be here soon. If they're not ready, I won't stick around just to watch this fall apart. She's so stubborn, though. I just hope it doesn't get her killed this time.
You're the only one here who can convince Sam to leave. Talk to her.
I tried.
Try again. She needs to be ready to run, and so do the kids.
The Fairbanks kept me safe, but I don't know if I can do the same for them.
She kind of reminds me of Jane from season 2. I mean, the game season 2, not the TV show. What's over here? Cute.
Poor Greg.
Diploma.
I remember getting my law degree. Doesn't mean much now.
Whoa. Come on, stop doing that. Let's see what's in here. Letter?
John, take care of our children and take care of yourself.
Oh, it's a suicide note.
I'm sorry. I know that doesn't help or explain anything, but it's true. I can't stand watching you and the kids suffer. Knowing what's going to happen to me and what I'll become. Better to spare you that pain.
Oh, was she going to turn? She was like dying.
I love you more than anything. Sophie.
She could have held out a bit longer though. I don't know. I don't know. Can I go downstairs? Okay, let's go find Pete. Here? No. Still some left.
This must be how they reinforce the gate.
Fire and
right behind you.
Shoot. Looks like they were ready for anything. Almost anything.
We can start a fire. Oh, come on, she's still fixing the house.
Hey Sam.
Hey. Something you need?
I ran into James inside. Should really go talk to him.
I know. I know nothing I say is gonna make it any better. Paige thinks we're not safe here. Now we need to move on. Bet she's trying to convince you to leave too. She's wanted out of here for a while. Guess she's found her chance.
I think Paige was right, Sam. We can't stay here. Think about it. Is this house really worth dying over?
It's not just the house. It's just so much of this place is my dad. It's all of us. He worked his way up from nothing. Took a job cleaning houses, paid his way through law school. When he bought this house, it was proof that he'd made a better life for us. We grew up here. Maybe I'm crazy, but I can't let that all be for nothing.
Your dad wouldn't want you to die for it.
He was so proud of what he built. This place kept us safe. We were happy here.
Norma doesn't care about any of that. She's coming here, and she's not gonna stop just because this place has sentimental value.
I know. I don't expect you to understand.
Just tell her that.
You found the bag.
Yeah, here.
Thanks. I should get back to work.
I wish I had more dialogue options.
Worked better than I thought.
Okay, I can't go there. Where do I go next? Sam's room.
Wow. She's been all over the world. Those days are long gone now. Sam's passport. This must be her mother. Sophia Fairbanks. Almost out of space in these.
Well, she went to...
Sam's mom wrote this. Took Sam to see the Eiffel Tower. I don't think she cared much for it, but we found a little shop on the way back and ate about 50 macarons each. I blame the pregnancy. Sam blames our shared sweet tooth. At least Sam has some happy memories to hold on to.
Where is the other room? Where is... Where am I supposed to go?
Norma will see right through this.
Wash his face.
You know, my hands hurt a little bit. You got any ointment lying around?
Yeah, well, when Norma gets here, she'll bust down that little gate of yours.
And tune you up good.
Just march on in. Majestic as fuck.
Come in here just like you did? Didn't work out too well for you.
Yeah, well. Don't be a stranger.
Ah, that's how kids didn't look at it.
Here, Pete.
Thanks. This is a mess. Can't believe how fucking stupid I was.
I already gave Sam a gun.
Get so focused on finding people. I wasn't putting the crew first. I didn't insist on looking. But I didn't turn us around and lead us here.
It's not your fault, Pete. You didn't know this would happen.
Oak knew. I should have fucking listened. You'd think after all this time, after everything we've had to do to survive, people would want to help each other. But no. They're just guarding what's theirs and taking out whoever gets in their way.
Yep. That's just how humans are.
I don't know why I even bother trying to help anymore. Doesn't seem worth it. Maybe I was just fooling myself.
There are two types of people in this world.
There were people worth helping. And now we all have to pay the price for it.
Maybe you're right. Maybe this time it wasn't.
We have to get my crew back. Hopefully my boat is still in one piece. Shit. What the hell are we gonna do? If Norma's coming for a fight, are we really prepared for that? These kids, they aren't up for this.
Sounds like Paige wants to run. Not the worst idea.
I'm not leaving without my guys, but once we get them back...
Yeah, negotiating doesn't work with Norma. I don't think it does. And fighting, I don't think it will work. We'll go down without a fight.
I'm fine, Michonne. Just make sure everyone else is ready when Norma comes.
He sounds a bit like Lee Everett. Oh, wait.
Not gonna be able to look at that the same way again. James and Alex, wonder how they'll get through all this.
Look, look, see that matchless host. March along in the Lord they boast. For Pharaoh's army got drowned in. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. For Pharaoh's army got drowned in. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Who are the people who look so grand? They must be headed for the promised land. For Pharaoh's army got drowned in. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. They are so happy, just hear them sing. They must be looking for the coming king. For Pharaoh's army got drowned in. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you weep.
Look at the dustbin. I should do that. It's getting worse. Are we done?
Oh, hey. I'm looking for Alex. Have you seen him? I want him to be there when I say a few words for Dad. Even if I couldn't bury him. He wasn't at Mom's funeral. He should be there for this.
Alex asked about his father. I didn't know what to tell him.
I'll go talk to him.
You'll find him in his fortress.
I wish he didn't have to see him like this.
Never mind. Never mind. Oh well.